Hey everybody, so in this video, we're going to take a look at doing some basic music implementation in FMOD Studio. Before we get started, let's take a quick look at our game so we'll have some idea of what we're trying to achieve with our score implementation. So this is the survival shooter tutorial that Unity published a couple of years ago, and I've made a few changes for our purposes. Let's go ahead and play the game for a minute, and then I'll explain what we're trying to do with the score. Okay, so as you can hear, what happens is we start the game and we get some idle music while we wait for some enemies to spawn. And once the enemies spawn, then we move into combat music. Now we could actually change the score as the combat intensity increases, but we're not doing that just yet. Now I've set the enemies to spawn a little more slowly than in the original tutorial so that we actually have a chance to kill all the bad guys and get back to the idle music, which really wouldn't be possible in the original tutorial. So the third bit of music that you hear occurs when the player dies, and then we jump back to the idle music as the level restarts. So let's flip over to FMOD Studio and take a look at how we actually implement this. Okay, so here we are in our FMOD project. So as you can see, I've got a music event that's already created here, and two parameters that are communicating with the game. One is our enemy counter, which is going to ramp up from zero. I capped it at 30, but it could go even higher, I suppose. And our player health, which starts at 100 and works its way down to zero when the player dies. Okay, so we've got those two parameters. And then you can see down here in the track area, I've got just a single audio track that I named Music, and a master track. Okay, so here's what we're going to want to do. Before we get started, you'll want to make sure that you switch the timeline over to beats, because we're going to be thinking in terms of bars and beats. And I'll drag a couple of clips in, and we can just get some music happening here. So I'm going to hit Command 3 on the Mac, Control 3 on Windows, or go to Window Audio Bin. And I've already got a music folder imported here, and you can see that I've got some exploratory music on a clip. I'll go ahead and drag that in. A couple different levels of combat intensity. We're just going to do one for today. So I'll drag one of those in. And I've got a death clip here, so I'll go ahead and bring that in as well. So those are the three pieces of music that we're going to work with. And of course, in a FMOD event, I can just play these left to right like you would in any DAW. Okay, so these are the same three music clips that you heard before. Okay, so how do we get these to be interactive and actually respond to the changes in these parameters? That's what we're trying to do today. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a tempo marker here. That way my bars and beats grid will actually match up to the clips that I have. Now these happen to be at 120 and 4/4 time, so I don't have to make any changes here, but if you needed to, you can click in here and change the tempo or the meter. Okay, so now that my grid is set up, I can start putting in some other logic track controls to actually drive the interactivity. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put in markers for each of these three clips. So I'll say add marker, and I can drag it down to get a new lane in the logic track. And I will call this intro. And then I'll add another marker here, and I'll call that combat. And I'm right-clicking here, by the way, inside the logic track. Right-click, add marker, and we'll call this death. Okay, so we've got our three markers in there, and this is actually how we're going to navigate through these clips, is by jumping to these markers. So you want to make sure they're in there and that everything is precisely aligned. You might want to double-check. Make sure these are right on the grid. Note, by the way, that I'm actually leaving space between the clips, and I found this is actually a really helpful thing to do when you're working in FMOD. There's no reason why these clips need to touch each other, and by leaving space, it's a little bit easier to kind of see where things are going, and as we add in the transitions, you'll see in a second that leaving some space is actually really helpful. Okay, so when the event starts to play, it's going to play the intro. And we want to make sure that it continues to play that until some enemies emerge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the explore clip, right click, and choose new loop region. Now I'll drag this guy down. I'll make yet another lane in the logic track. And you can see that now I've got this loop indicator here. And when the explore loop plays, it will continue to loop until it has some reason to move on. Okay, so let's check that out. Okay, so now we have to figure out how we get from this exploratory loop into combat. There are a few different ways to do this, but we're gonna do this the simplest possible way for this tutorial. So I'll right click on the logic track and I'm gonna say, add transition to combat. Okay, and this little flag comes up. And again, you can see already why I left some space in here. So what I'll do is click on that flag if it isn't already selected. And then you can see the conditions will pop up down here in the deck. What I'm going to do is add a condition to this and tie it to the parameter called enemies. Okay. And then it wants to know what value for enemies will actually cause this transition to trigger. What will cause it to be true? And what we're going to set is anything more than one. So 1 to 30, because we're just going to do one level of combat intensity for now. Anything above one will cause FMOD to jump from the exploratory loop over to combat. Okay. So let's test that out. First I'll leave enemies at 0, and then I'll increase it so that it makes the jump. Okay, so obviously our next step is to make combat loop. So I'll go ahead and right click on combat, make a new loop region, drag that down so that it's in the lane with the other one. And now what we want to do is have the possibility of jumping from combat back to explore. So I'll do the same thing again, right click in the logic track, choose transition to intro. Okay. And again, you can move these to other lanes if you want for clarity. So now I'll click on to intro. And once again, its conditions will come up down here in the deck, and I'll say add condition enemies. And this one's simple. It's only going to go back to the intro when the enemies are at 0. So it'll continue to loop on itself until the enemy's parameter decreases down to 0. And again, I modified the survival shooter in Unity so that there's big gaps between the guys being spawned, and you can easily get it back down to 0. Okay, so let's test that out. We'll start from intro, we'll go to combat, and then we'll make it jump back. So we've got the basic interaction happening already. So our exploratory loop plays. When an enemy spawned, we jump to combat. If we can manage to get the enemy count back down to 0, then we'll jump back to our exploratory loop. Okay, so we really just need one more thing here, and that is to be able to go from combat to death. There's really no way to get from explore to death in the game. There's always going to be at least one enemy spawned if you die. So you really don't need to actually be able to go from intro directly to death. We really just need the option of going from combat to death. So again, I'll right click, add transition to death, make sure it's right on the bar. And then we'll go down into the conditions and we'll say add parameter condition, and we'll tie it to the player health. And in this case, all we're really looking for is when the player health gets down to 0. And then that is going to jump us automatically to death. So let's test that one out. Okay, so now the entire event is going to re-trigger when our character, when the actual player respawns. That's just how the game is set up. The whole scene is re-triggered. So we're not actually going to create some logic that takes us from death back to our intro loop. All we're going to do is let death play out, then the game will automatically re-trigger this event and start us back at the intro. What I am going to do is shorten this a little bit, so I'm just going to click and drag to trim this clip down, and I'm going to add a fade. So I just want to make sure that our death music fades out before the intro starts up again. So let's just listen to that for a second. Okay, so we could spend some more time getting that to sound really good, but we'll just leave it there for now. That's pretty much it for this event. As you can see, we'll start playing, we'll get caught in the intro loop. When enemies are spawned, we'll follow the combat transition into our combat loop. Then if enemies go back down to zero, we'll jump back to the intro. Or if we die, we will jump to the death marker. And then that will just play out with the little fade that I added. And then the level will restart and this event will be triggered all over again. Okay, so we'll go ahead and build this. And now our updated music event will automatically be loaded into the game. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump back over to Unity and check this out. Well, so as you can hear, our death cue needs a little bit of work. It didn't really need to fade out quite so fast. So that's pretty much it. We've got our three clips playing. The intro music plays. Then when an enemy spawns, we jump over to the combat music. And then if we die, we jump from combat to the death clip that just plays out. And then the whole thing re-triggers when the scene is relaunched. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this video. If some of these basic FMOD concepts aren't familiar, you'll definitely want to go to the FMOD TV YouTube channel and look at some of the videos they have there. And I'll be back soon with part two, and we'll look at using layers and some automation to sort of take things to the next level of complexity. See you then.